Hello and welcome to Affinity. Let's have a look at the colour replacement brush. Normally you can't see it because, you know, typically when you start off it's hidden here. What you do is go to the paintbrush tool, right click on that, and there's the colour replacement brush tool underneath. On the surface it's quite easy to use. So if I just pick a colour here, let's say some green, and then I go over here somewhere, you can see the preview under the brush here. That's going to be green. The trick though is the moment I click with the left mouse button, it's going to sample the colour underneath it and then try to replace all the other colour that it sees like that as you paint. So I click and paint, and what you can see here, when it catches up, it uses a lot of processor time. So yeah, see it'll gradually catch up and fills in things here. Notice it's missed a bit out, and this is because it works to a tolerance. It looks exactly underneath where you click in the middle of the brush and looks depending on the tolerance you've got here. So I do a Control Z. I'll typically do this a couple of times to try it out. So I'll put that up, say 13%. That's just a tiny bit more, and look at what happens now. You see, we're going to wait for it to catch up. See, there's more there. What you can do again is you can go over the top of it. You can just even do single clicks. Wait for the preview to appear so you can see where it's going to do. You might need to zoom in on things and so on. And see there, I'm waiting for it to catch up with me. And then you can have quite a significant effect on it. See, you can paint entire areas like this. If you go slowly, it will keep up. But you have to find the right tolerance for it to do. See, even there, there's the edges. For the edges, you probably need to zoom in to get that right. By and large, it can be a bit difficult around edges because you then find you're overflowing into the next area. But it's a useful tool if you've got nice clean edges and you want a quick change, or at least to do a larger area, and then you're going to tidy up with the rest of it. Otherwise, it's the brush stuff is all fairly the same as other brushes. The only things here which are important are the tolerance, as we've just seen, as to how sloppy it is. Sample continuously means it will keep on sampling. In other words, you know, when you normally do it, it just takes a sample immediately, but then it sticks to that. But this means it'll do on all colours, which means you can use it. If I click on that, you can just paint anywhere with this and it will try to. It's a generic re-colouring brush, so I can just paint over entire areas and just use this to change the general colour of it. So I can just keep painting and things will, you know, when it catches up. It's continuously resampling so that it doesn't worry too much about it. It's not trying to stick to the original colour. So there we go. So it's fairly simple. The other point here is contiguous, and that is when that's clicked, it will try, it looks for adjacent pixels, and if you keep going it will... it shouldn't find other pixels even if they're the same colour elsewhere. There's just each pixel it changes has got to be next to one it's already changed. Okay, there we go. Nice little tool. Used appropriately, it's handy. Sometimes it's a bit annoying. I use it occasionally. Okay, thank you very much for watching.